Welcome to Tips and Tricks for Show Control. This video reveals shortcuts and hints intended to increase speed and efficiency when working with Daktronics Show Control. Pre-production often involves creating and editing scripting buttons. To quickly jump to the properties of an existing button, hold down Control on the keyboard and right-click the button to be edited. Copy and paste functions are also available to ease the process of moving buttons within a workspace. The keyboard shortcuts Ctrl-X, Ctrl-C, and Ctrl-V work respectively as cut, copy, and paste. Multiple buttons may be selected simultaneously by drawing a box around them with the mouse or by holding Ctrl when left-clicking on the buttons. To quickly duplicate a button, hold down Ctrl, then drag and drop the button. Duplicating a button and changing out a step in the properties, such as the file in step 4, can be a big time saver when loading content with tight deadlines. Use colors to keep your workspace organized. Click the color wheel while editing button properties to assign the button a color for easy identification. Use empty buttons as header labels for your columns. To create an empty button, choose System Control in step 1, Wait in step 2, and leave step 3 on 1. Thumbnail images can be added to a button by hovering over the button and pressing Ctrl-R. To customize the thumbnail, open the button properties and choose Select Thumbnail. Click Browse to choose a specific file. Mapping a hotkey to commonly used buttons makes it convenient for quick playback without having to search for the button. Use the hotkey icon in the bottom right corner of Display Studio to assign a keyboard shortcut to any button in the workspace. Click the plus sign, then browse to the desired button. Click Save when finished. If your system has multiple signs or zones, the monitor wall can fill up quickly. To save room, monitors, especially fascias or ribbons, can be stacked vertically up to 3 monitors tall. Right-click the monitor wall and choose Properties. Drag one monitor on top of another to stack them, then use the double-sided arrows at the edge and the zoom tool to customize the fit. Click Save when finished to return to normal operation. Making a copy of your workspace is useful if you host postseason or tournament games and do not want to change or clutter your regular season workspace. To do this, click the hub and choose Save As. Name it Postseason. Now you can add, edit, or delete buttons without altering the original workspace. After a show build is complete, use the Verify Buttons tool located in the hub to check that all buttons will execute and there's no missing content or broken links within your workspace. You can also verify individual tabs or buttons by right-clicking them respectively and choosing Verify Tab or Button. In Content Studio, to clean up and quickly align multiple items, use the Align tools located in the Arrange section of the Home tab. Select multiple elements by drawing a box around them with the mouse or hold down Ctrl and select items to align. The 6 direction options, along with the 4 spacing options beneath, provide quick solutions for aligning elements. To quickly adjust the length of a layout, hold the Alt key on the keyboard while dragging the layout layer in the timeline. This will ensure all the elements in that layout will adjust to the same duration. Elements that are locked will not change using this shortcut. The canvas background may be adjusted and customized by selecting Content Studio options from the hub in the upper left corner. In the Environment Options section, users can select the default layout and page time along with a canvas checkerboard setting. When searching through image and video files using Windows Explorer, you can also drag and drop these files straight into Content Studio rather than importing them from the Home or Insert tab. For displays using a DMP8000 player, the Multiple Fields section allows for combining multiple text boxes and data fields. This feature also allows for flexibility in creating subfolders within the Media RTD folder. This multiple fields dialog may be opened with any text or data field selected. Choose from field, text, or directory and insert the desired information. View the combining data fields tutorial for more details on this feature. This concludes the tutorial for tips and tricks for show control. Continue to other videos to learn more about your Daktronics control system.